guys, welcome back. It is an amazing sight to see when your little one figures out that hand-knee coordination and they begin to crawl. They get really fast and they take off. It's one of the most significant developmental milestones for your baby, but with it comes some new challenges. So here are my nuggets on how to tackle locomotion. First, crawling is a big deal developmentally. It impacts brain development, socio-emotional development, and visual skills development. So in the brain, when they learn that coordination of right-left movement, actually the right and left side of the brain start to communicate to one another. It lays the foundation for motor coordination. Socio-emotional development, when that crawling kicks in and they see that toy across the room, I want that toy. I'm setting a goal. I'm gonna go try to attain it. So they start to experience joy and accomplishment. They also experience those feelings of frustration. I see that toy, but I can't quite get to it. Or I'm trying to crawl over mommy's leg and I can't figure it out. So they experience positive and negative emotions with crawling. It also impacts their visual skills because babies have to look at the ground when they're crawling. Then they look up across the room, then they refocus down, then they look up. So their vision is constantly adapting and adjusting, and it really strengthens those visual skills. Number two, crawling increases separation anxiety. Internally, they are really physically motivated now to move away and explore, but emotionally, they want to come right back and be attached. So there's kind of a conflict for them. So as they crawl away, you're gonna see an increase in those anxious feelings about moving away. Number three, it's time to baby-proof. This is extremely important. When your baby starts to crawl and move away from you, we wanna make sure they're safe. You can call a consultant to come out and help you with it. You can research it online. Get a list from your pediatrician. My rule of thumb has always been baby-proof everything, that if the baby gets hurt, it's irreversible. Stairs, banisters, the toilet in case they fall in head first, the fireplace, the stove, the oven, the doors to the outside, especially when you have a pool, that should be gated as well. Some other things that are important are the blind cords, electrical sockets, electrical cords, the computer setup, anything that's down in the cabinets that's poisonous or glass or sharp or small objects, you need to move them up out of the baby's reach and make sure they are nice and secure and safe, and definitely want to earthquake proof that security so your baby remains safe on the ground below. Look, I don't think it's as important to baby-proof the drawers and the cabinets. It'll definitely make your life easier with a crawler, but their fingers getting pinched, that can heal very quickly, but sticking their hand on top of a stove will not. So make sure you make choices to keep your baby safe as they venture out and they're moving all over the place. Next, crawling happens between 6 to 12 months. I don't want you to focus too much on what your baby is doing compared to another baby of the same age, because it's about having them pull to standing or crawl by 12 months. Whether it happens at 6 months or 11 and a half months, it really doesn't matter developmentally for your baby. If your baby is not crawling or pulling to standing by 12 months, please consult with your pediatrician and or a physical therapist to help resolve that. My next nugget is, find new tricks to get your daily tasks done. A basic diaper change now kind of becomes a nightmare when you have a crawler. They flip over so fast and take off. So get something creative, like maybe a toy or an object they're only allowed to hold during diaper changes to engage them. Or I used to lay next to them on the ground, pop my leg over their belly so they couldn't flip over and change really fast. Get creative to help with those daily tasks. And finally, stick with your sleep plan. When you lay your babies down, there's a reflex that starts in their back once they get really mobile and crawling around. It's like the second their back hits that crib, bam, they pop straight up. And it can really make sleep challenging as they're getting used to learning how to pull to standing and crawling. Stick with your same sleep plan to help them transition through this development so they'll go back to sleeping much better. Crawling is such an amazing, fun, and playful time to experience with your babies. You can chase them around the house, they'll chase you, they'll roll a ball and chase after it. It is really great fun. I hope these nuggets will help you tackle it and adjust to the new challenges that come along with crawling. Thanks so much for joining me. I'll see you guys next time.